Jones is out. Can it get over the top of Anderson?
Tracks
all the way back
in.
It does. And he's lobbed in. What a goal!
Inundated. So popular.
Now I'm strong enough for both of us. Both of us, both of us, both of us. I am a giant. Stand up on my shoulders. Tell me what you see. I am a giant. We'll be breaking boulders underneath our feet.
Preliminary final night here at the AMNA Championships, coming to you live from the Casey Stadium in Melbourne, Victoria. My name's Dave Mills. I'm joined in commentary by coaching extraordinaire, Australian men's reserve coach and Australian men's masters coach, Jenny Lewis. Jenny, we're watching a match here in the mixed reserves division between the mighty Queensland of Maroons and the New South Wales side. I know you coach in this division, in the upper mixed division. What are your thoughts on this one?
I think this is going to be a tight game. I had a look at New South playing yesterday against Victoria, and they really, Victoria were undefeated, but New South Wales gave them a really great match-up. And I'm also aware of the talent that the Queensland team has, so I think I'm excited. I'm really looking forward to a good game.
Excellent work. Yes, yeah, so the... These two teams have played before in the rounds, and it was a win to the Queensland side, 56-32. They completely dominated them, and that was from a few days ago. Today, both these teams have already played today. Queensland took care of South Australia, 65-32, and New South Wales took on the might of the ADF, and they won 57-28. So both teams coming off some very good wins, and both got a lot to play for, because the winner will take on Victoria. Victoria just beat the ACT, so they're already in the final. And that final, of course, will be tomorrow night at 9 a.m. So the team lists are still coming to us. I've been given the Queensland team. The shooter is Dunphy. The goal attack is Renata. Sherpig is the wing attack. The centre is Gunn. Shelford Salt, the wing defence. Bowmaker, the GD. And Anthony Lusty is the goalkeeper. So the... Just waiting for the final changes with the New South Wales side. So it looks like Emily Kirk was to start, and she's gone. It's very confusing what they've done here. So we'll come to back to you with the lineup for WA, for New South Wales, sorry.
This is it.
Okay, so the list we have, we've just been handed it, that's come well. So Rochelle Bizard shooting, Steve Catalano the goal attack, Holland is the wing attack, Maddie Kirk is the centre, Nathan Dart the goal, the wing defence, Emily Kirk is the sister of Maddie, is the goal defence, and Simon Kluelo is the goalkeeper. So the umpires for this match... They gave that to me as well. Having a shocking time here. Sean Steele, Deanna Stainer, and the reserve is El Bonassay. So we're underway. The first centre pass goes to New South Wales. They get us underway. Queensland heavily favoured to win this. Jenny, what's your tip in the match and by how much?
After watching New South put up such a competitive game against Victoria last night, I think they'll make it a close game, so I'm predicting Queensland by 5.
Queensland by 5? Selling them a bit short there, I feel. I'll go Queensland by 25. So
we'll have a bet on that, whoever's closest.
We'll have a Pepsi. We're away early. Dunphy makes the first. of the 25 lead that Queensland are looking for. So, Gunn in the centre. Great to have Sophie Gunn back in the team. She's been missing for a couple of years and good to have her back.
Very direct to post at the moment, the Queensland side. So New South Wales will have to look at how they can slow that ball up entering the circle.
Okay.
And there's a good touch by Anthony Lusty, very athletic goalkeeper.
So Lusty with the tip. So New South Wales start again from the side. Didn't call for the obstruction.
I was very impressed in the previous game with the wing attack for New South Wales. Holland, she very composed and in wing defence caused quite a bit of disruption.
So another pass into Dunphy. He's unable to handle that one. That one had a little bit too much on it from Renata. So they've got a lot of depth, the Queenslanders. So we'll see changes coming thick and fast.
New South here have been very patient in attack to hit the edge of the circle.
Bowmaker making it very hard for the shooter, but she gets around her. And replies. We're tied up at twos. New South Wales with the centre. Lusty nearly.
And he has created the...
Looks like a footwork call back in the centre
there,
third.
So
Bowmaker with it. Throws the gun. Bowmaker... incredibly fit. We haven't heard her for a couple of years as well. She's incredibly fit. So
for anyone listening, if we hear Dave saying we, it's because he's a long-time Queensland coach.
Oh, absolutely. Long-time Queensland player. But that was back before most of our viewers were born.
So I spent 10 years in Sydney, so I'll have to balance that out with the New South Wales calls.
Aren't you a Western Australian state rep?
Yes.
So it's where the blood runs. Queensland with it. Renata with the ball, great feed in.
Good touch then by Klulau. He just needs to get in and contest against the shooter from Queensland.
The big man Dunphy makes no mistake, he's got three. So. Zach Dunphy.
So New South Wales centre pass.
Nicknamed Phil. Four to two to the Queenslanders.
New South Wales are nicely structured in their approach to the circle then. The goal attack just got caught out with a held ball, so maybe just needs to let that go. He's got the height to be able to not worry too much about the lean over the shot and can potentially just go straight to the post.
Bowmaker fumbles. Lusty created the turnover with the held ball. Queensland slow in transition. Back to Bowmaker. Looking for, there she is, Gunn. Not sure to throw it in. She's got an amazing pass. Kicks out, back to Gunn again. This time to Renata. Little short shot, but Zach gets the rebound. Second chance. Misses that as well, but gets a penalty this time. They say three times a charm.
And
there it is.
And a lovely shot to finish.
So she missed one and gets one. So, Gunn with the ball. Queensland out early, 5-2.
Good drive from...
Sophie Gunn.
Sophie Gunn. Yep.
She's been in this team before, been away for a couple of years due to career, and now she's back, bigger than ever.
What's she been doing with career, Dave?
I just knew she was working away up from Brisbane, so...
Okay.
So up in the Charters Tower region.
So back home and back now, creating a lot of opportunity for the Queensland.
We snabbled her as soon as she came home. Like the prodigal
son
returning.
So New South Wales have an opportunity here. Good offload. And nice shot.
Steve Catalano. Bowmaker and Gunn, they're best friends and two of the fittest people you'll ever meet.
And straight access to the circle there as well. So it's looking like a a tough gig for the New South Wales defenders here, but I'm sure that they're up to the standard and they'll work their way in as the game goes on. I've worked with the goalkeeper for New South Wales with the Australian Masters team, and I know he'll never give in and will contest every ball.
So another turnover for the Queenslanders, getting it through cautiously through the mids. Patience being a virtue. So it's unusual to see a male wing attack, isn't it? And usually that's a female position.
We're seeing it quite a bit more in the mixed division. We saw it quite a lot in the mixed open division this year. It creates a mismatch. So certainly we used a wing attack in the first half of our semi today as a male wing attack, creating a mismatch and creating opportunity through doing that.
And the miss there to Renata gives New South Wales a chance to eat into this lead. She takes the shot or pass off, steps in, going to go to the hoop. Strong.
And a lovely shot.
And why wouldn't you? That's Rochelle Bizard. Gun to Sherpig.
So on the last play, New South Wales confused the space quite nicely in the circle. Unfortunately, that's been advanced, which makes it a bit trickier, but they've done well there to get a deflection.
There's been some loose play from Renata in the last couple of minutes. A missed shot, a step, then a very bad pass back to Gunn, giving New South Wales an opportunity when Queensland were in total control.
Yeah, New South Wales is looking quite structured on their approach to the circle, and it's starting to pay off for them. And a good pass over and a nice take by Steve Catalano. And finished well. So an opportunity for New South Wales here to close the gap.
They've done well. It was 7-2, now 7-5. Sherpig with the intercept couldn't get the slops. Catalano, strong against Bowmaker.
He's got a good reach, but a strong rebound there by Anthony Lusty.
Lusty will get Queensland going, which he does. Bowmaker on the drive to a best mate Gunn. Back to Bowmaker. Looks in, finds Renata. Another casual pass. That's three she's thrown just in this first period. So needs to tighten that up, single-handedly keeping the Blues in it. So
That's a harsh call, Dave.
Absolutely. Caught like I see it.
Okay, so New South Wales approaching the circle here.
And the score is back. So we know we've had a technical issue with the scoreboard. It's now correct, 7-5 to the Queenslanders.
So we've had a nice patient approach now by New South Wales, and they've finished it off.
7-6. So after looking like Queensland were going to run away with it, the Blues have come back to 7-6.
And good contest there, but well taken and finished off by Dunphy Queensland.
And we have a step call, footwork call. Picking up a lot of advice from the New South Wales coach, wanting to block the vision. And it's working at the moment. Queensland struggling to get it through. Great drive by Bowmaker.
Okay, Queensland approaching the edge of the circle. There's some good pressure being put on by New South Wales, but just that big target at the end.
Yeah.
Dunphy, hard to stop.
Gunn looks for him every time.
Yeah, there are some really good feeds that have been put into him.
So Shelford Salt's coming off at wing defence. She's being replaced by Georgia Elliott.
And a bit of a loose centre pass there. Sometimes when there's a substitution, it can create that. So New South Wales need to capitalise on this one. Strong take by Dart. And a nice outlet, just need to be patient with the offload there. So good pressure from the Queensland defenders.
Lusty did well. He's actually more known as a shooter than a keeper. He's doing a great job there. in the spot, slightly unfamiliar to him. Boehmaker driving through the middle, taking every second pass. Renata looks in.
And there's a good ball in.
And a step call. So Zach Dunphy, unnecessary error.
So a good transition by New South, but they lost patience with the last pass, so maybe just need to throw in an extra pass in between to have a better access to feed the circle.
Maddie Kirk with a long bomb.
And another opportunity for New South. Bit of a stray ball from Lusty, which is fairly unusual for him. I'm sure he'll tidy that up. Long shot missed, and another opportunity for Queensland to convert.
Misses the shot. This time, going with the shorter player to take the pass in. Kicks it to Elliott. George Elliott, who can read an intercept better than most. So, Lusty finds her. Looks down. Under Boehmaker. Gun to Boehmaker. We'll call that a lot. Played nearly 12 minutes, Queensland by 3.
Fairly low scoring, which reflects a final often because players are a little bit nervous to start with, but they feels like they've settled nicely into the game now.
So Dunphy makes sure of the shot, 10-6. As you say, both teams settling well. New South Wales, oh, just a loose pass there. Given Bazaar no chance of that one. Coach not happy. Having a little bit to say. So Boehmaker with the throw in.
Some good pressure on the outlet by New South Wales then, so seeing if they can contain this ball and create another opportunity.
Steve Catalano with the pressure. So Lusty looks in. Boehmaker again, running miles and miles at the moment, finds Gunn. Onto Renata, she'll look in. Great pass.
Very good pass.
And Dunphy, Zach Dunphy with the layup.
Not a lot a keeper can do when there's a well-placed pass into a tall holding shooter, but we'll see how much they can disrupt as the game progresses.
11-6. Boehmaker with the penalty.
Queensland are getting good front position and getting some good position around the edge of the circle to be able to place those balls into their shooters.
Great drive by by Renata there, but the umpire took it back outside. Should have played the advantage. Long shot coming up. She sets for it. Passes off. And gone for a hell ball.
Okay, so that was well.
No, nope, obstruction on Dunphy. He must have put his arm up or something. So, Elliott.
Clemow's doing some good work getting around the body, which will create those opportunities. And here we have New South advancing to the circle.
Quick feed. Boehmaker does well. Queensland throw.
And a missed shot by Buzzard that they were unable to rebound. So, but another opportunity here to chase in and offload to her goal attack. Nice positioning by Catalano there, and she was a bit off balance. So let's see if he can finish this.
And he can. So Steve Catalano makes the margin just 4. We're inside the last minute, or just about. Queensland, we're in control. Unforced errors keeping New South Wales in it. Remembering last time these two teams played, the margin was 24. So
bit of an errant pass from Maddie Kirk there, but well pulled in by Catalano in goal attack.
We're watching some bad netball at the moment, Jen. Lots of errors, both sides, stray passes.
Finals netball.
Pressure.
Creates pressure. So let's see if we can finish off the shot.
Got pinged for bringing the hand down. Looked like Bazaar brought the ball up into him. Recall
yep.
time.
And stepped in as well. So. So Catalano protecting the rebound. Let's see if Bazaar can finish off.
Can. So 11-8. We're deep inside the last minute. Gunn with the ball. From Sherpig. He looks in. Finds Renata. Renata, the long bomb. Ill-directed. Okay. No not a bad pass. New South Wales got enough time to score. There's no need for that.
Good positioning by Simon Clulow on the final play to make sure he was in front to get that deflection.
So we slow it down enough, and Queensland take the first 11-8. New South Wales look like they've gone a couple of times. Unforced errors by the mighty Maroons has brought the side back into it. What will happen in the second quarter, we will find out after these messages.
Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au.
Welcome back to the preliminary final at the AMNA Championships for 2019, coming to you live from the Casey Stadium in Melbourne, Victoria. We are watching a preliminary final between the might of the Queensland side in the reserves division. It's in mixed against the New South Wales, a real state of the origin batch. It's 11-8 to the Maroons. We've got some shooting stats. Queensland in the first quarter, Zach Dunphy hit 9 from 10, Renata 2 from 4. For New South Wales, Bazaird hit 5 from 7 and Catalano 3 from 4. My name's Dave Mills. Joining me in commentary is Australian coach of many teams, Masters and Reserves, 23s, Trans-Tasman assistant, Jenny Lewis. Jenny, what did you think of the first quarter?
I could see that there were nerves out there, and I think the players started to settle into the game as the quarter went on. Obviously, Queensland are a well-drilled team and have got a terrific target up forward in Dumfries. I think New South Wales are hanging in there. They've got some good structure, bringing the ball through court. So if they can stick to that and maintain that, then they'll keep themselves in the battle here.
Wise words. We're getting ready for the start of the second. New South Wales coach being fairly animated throughout the first quarter. Queensland looking fairly calm. Appears to be no changes to the Maroon side, no changes to New South Wales. So, and oh, there might be a change.
There's a change to.
Yep. So they've changed the goal attack. Renata, who wasn't having her best game, has come off, and Shelford Salt has come on. So, obviously, coach not happy with what he saw.
And so New South Wales, the shooter is releasing the circle. Nice offload, but unfortunately a replayed ball, so an opportunity for Queensland to convert and extend.
So Queensland in transition.
And a good contest there by Catalano. Always good when a shooter makes a mistake and then they can then intercept and get the ball back. Something a coach loves to see.
So, unfortunately, Queensland not able to make the penalty pay. So, showing my biasness there. And the Blues have a chance
to convert in a great shot by Rochelle Bizard.
And they do. So, the margin two. We've played one in the second quarter. Another contest.
Good contest there from Nathan Darden has created the turnover. I thought in the first quarter he'd been fairly tight on the wing attack for Queensland and certainly making him earn his possessions, and it's paid off now with a turnover to him.
So, New South, if they score here, they're centre next to have a chance to tie it up.
A bit of confusion then between the two goalies for New South Wales. They were both contesting the same ball, which creates a turnover to Queensland. And then a held ball. So we've had a little bit of tennis here through the attack end for the beginning of the second quarter. Dave, back to Queensland again.
It's tough to watch at present. And Bowmaker. She could finally settle. She does. Gives it to Gunn. Gunn looks in. Better play. Nice play by Shelford Salt.
Some very quick ball work.
Shot was not good.
Yep, and grabbed in by Simon Clulow.
So Queensland have been stuck on 11 for a while.
Great take then by Tiua Holland from New South Wales. Very athletic player, and I was very impressed with her. She's in wing attack today. I was very impressed with her game in wing defence yesterday as well. She's shown some terrific athleticism.
So, New South, Georgia Elliott making it difficult on the outside. Don't forget the margin, 2. Queensland had it out by as much as 5.
We've got a reset, a contact from the goal defence for Queensland there. Creates an opportunity for New South. Goal attack probably just needs to open up his body for the offload there. He's getting a little bit caught behind Lusty, which has meant the shooter had to take the long shot there.
So Baymaker with the throw-in finds Lusty. On to Elliott, back to Lusty. Queensland struggling to get it out of that goal third. Gunn grabs it.
Yeah, good
hands over.
New South to create the confusion through midcourt. So, and there's a good ball into Dumfrey, which he converts.
So Sherpig and Dumfrey connect. Queensland finally get their 12th.
It's a good contest from the Queensland goal defence at the centre pass, but called for contact.
Meg Bowmaker, that is. Lots of whistle being attracted to by the Queenslanders at the moment.
There's a long shot again from the New South Wales goal shooter. Maybe she could work it in a tiny bit closer to get that safer shot off. She does have a big target with her in Steve Catalano.
Lusty gets the boards, gets Queensland rolling. Good pass onto the big man. Zach Dunphy makes no mistake again. So hit 9 out of 10
very
in the first.
Nice centre pass there from Queensland, direct to the post.
So finally we're seeing some fluidity from the Queenslanders. So 3 straight now, 14-9. Lusty.
Just need a bit of placement on that ball. I think Lusty had a good hand in then. So
looks clean.
Lucky outlet for New South, but let's see if they can take that luck and convert it. And they do. So good shot there to Rochelle Bizard.
And push off there from Dunphy.
Yep, Simon Clulow's positioning very well on them, confusing the space, using his footwork to confuse the space so there's not an obvious hold on to pass to. And it's also making Queensland have to work the ball to the edge of the circle to offload that.
Steps in for the shot, makes no mistake,
nice
nothing
shot
but net.
From Bizard. So she does have some good shooting range there.
So Queensland, after leading by 4, back to just 2.
Yeah, this New South Wales team is tenacious.
They will not go away.
And
great
nice rebound there
by
Catalano. And again.
Probably should make sure of the shot this time, and does. Queensland giving up 3 bites of that cherry. So Dunphy's on. There it is. Gunn finally gets it to him.
Yeah, when New South Wales accesses the edge of the circle cleanly, then it's usually a pretty easy pass into Dunphy, and he's able to lock off those holds when there's a close feed.
So there's big ball for Catalano.
Big ball, and he tries to keep it in, but unfortunately for New South Wales, he was out of court, and another chance for Queensland to extend their lead.
So Bowmaker with the throw-in.
Awkward throw-in, which meant that there was a stepping call by Anthony Lusty. Here's an opportunity for New South Wales to convert.
And he's given away contact as well. So she gets
another nice shot from Michelle Bizard.
So another Queensland error makes it easier for New South Wales. 15-13. It's not a clean game, Jen.
It's a final. It's a typical final.
You call it a final, I call it rubbish.
That's what we love watching. So I think there's some really good pressure being put defensively by both teams as well, which is creating the turnover ball and creating the errors.
I've seen both these teams play as earlier today, and they were both slick outfits. This is not slick at all.
Yep. So this is what pressure does, but it's also what good defensive work does. I'm seeing some tight contest there. And David's now laughing at me because he thinks I'm being too nice.
A little bit too nice there, Jenny. Cool. Must be truthful.
Always got to be positive as well.
I'm positive this is not good quality netball. Great
There's
shot there
nice
by Catalano.
Shot by Catalano.
He certainly lifts the standard with that shot. Gun straight back to the centre. So Queensland working hard into their big man Dunphy. Goes
There's
for the
a
layup.
Big layup, and he doesn't convert. Almost a contest there by Catalano, but a good rebound by Dunphy.
You think he might be a netballer, Jen?
A basketballer?
Yeah,
I think there's a little bit of basketball showing there.
So, we're shaking here, our equipment's shaking.
We do end up in the men's mixed netball with quite a few ex-basketballers. Can take a while for them to convert to some of the nuances of the game at this level, but certainly seen some good success stories over the years, Dave.
Indeed. So the margin 2, we've played 8 in the second quarter. Queensland keep threatening to pull away, and then silly errors let New South Wales back in, and they are fighting hard, the Blues.
Just on the basketballers, it's a very interesting addition to the Open Men's Division this year with Victoria. They've got the centre from the Kenyan national basketball team, Desmond O'Reilly, playing.
He certainly
created some variety in the Open Men's grade.
Oh, didn't think he did. Anchored the left foot. Controversial call. Again, Queensland with the error. And the Blues will get a chance to make it 2.
That was a nice transition play by New South Wales. As I said earlier, that I really like the structure that they have through their midcourt and through their transition. They're being able to convert most of their turnover ball here.
Bowmaker working hard, needs some help from Elliott.
And a nice contest again from Dart.
Sherpy unable to get the ball. So
Maddie Kirk is putting some great pressure out front too for New South Wales. She's a the workhorse there. And
two of the more unusual passes you'd see in a game of netball. Both of them had snow on them. So that's how high they went. Got more whistle. This time it's Bowmaker. And makes it too easy. Catalano with no defender on him, able to plonk himself under the ring. So, still the margin 2, Queensland with it.
He's had a good court tournament, Catalano. I feel like he's built into the tournament as it goes on.
And there's a hell ball.
Certainly very rangy and really good target for New South Wales.
Bowmaker needing help from Elliott, not getting it. So, New South Wales got a chance here with their centre next to tie it up.
Good touch from Lusty. I'm confusing the space here, but New South Wales retain the ball. Retain this opportunity. Shoelace break. Gives us a chance to have a breath as well, Dave. There's a lot happening on court.
There is a lot of stuff happening on court. So and that's where we should leave it. New South Wales, very tenacious in defence and offence.
So another long shot from, and another successful long shot by Bizard. She's got some great range on her shots.
Looking magnificent
there
today. New South Wales, chance to tie it up.
A lot of patience being shown here by New South Wales.
So Elliott reads it well, forces the goal line throw in.
And a good take from Catalano, and if he can convert this, it matches back to even. So we've got game on, Dave.
Yeah, we do indeed. We've played nearly 2 quarters and it's 19 all. Queensland not clicking yet. That there was
a
forced pass.
Bit of a short ball that maybe Simon will regret that one. He's looking at his coach and he could have potentially got around to contest that one, but I'm sure he'll be on to the next short ball.
Not a lot of defence being shown by the Queenslanders, particularly from the offensive players. Lusty does well, finds Bowmaker with it. He gets it back. Weak
and
pass.
Good hand in from Catalano as well to expose the pass.
So
opportunity for Queensland to take the lead again.
Nice screen set.
Yeah, good screen, good ball.
Dunphy can't control his feet. Back to Dunphy. Contact on the outside by Show.
Great contest from Emily Kirk in goal defence then, which created that opportunity for the turnover. It connects well with her midcourt.
New South Wales can tie it up again.
Maddie Kirk doing a mountain of work in centre and linking the two ends beautifully here. And another lovely shot from Michelle Bizard. Really impressed with the shooting range, Dave, being a long-range shooter.
That was a long time ago. So, but yeah, she's certainly stepped up, hitting some massive long bombs. Queensland struggling a little bit to feed the shooter, looking for a long option every time. So Dunphy's up to the task. Zach Dunphy gives Queensland the narrowest of leads.
Okay, we've got 2:40 to go in the second quarter, and if New South can convert here, the game is all tied up. That's what a final should be like.
So Elliot with the contact.
Nice ball into the goal shooter and a good pull in.
Boehmaker got that clean,
so
I thought.
A penalty, yep.
Well, she takes the shot. Kicks out.
So.
Well, they had it under the ring, but we're taking it back because Boehmaker moved off.
And I think that was a pass.
Yeah, it was. We got the same result in the end.
And same result.
So 2 to go in the half, and it's Queensland 21, New South Wales 21. It is a true State of Origin bash. Great work there by Dunphy. He's strong, but definitely a basketballer, judging by that move. So a quick goal there keeps Queensland out by one.
Great touch there by the wing attack for Queensland.
Sherpig. Throw to New South.
Busty's doing some good work covering the Catalano. Making him have to work for every ball, but New South Wales have been very patient in front, and great ball, great release then. A little bit off balance, so release to the edge of the circle, and he's got another opportunity through a contact call to tie the game up.
And a miss there.
Miss shot.
Probably a bit too close for her. She likes the longies.
She's been nailing the long bombs.
should have stepped back. Elliot wants the ball, doesn't re-offer. Needs to drive in there as well. So Boehmaker with no one to throw to.
Yeah, good hands there from Catalano. He's definitely creating some pressure through the midcourt. But
Elliot, that's what she's best at.
Yeah, Maddie Kirk probably stepped into that ball, so she'll correct
inside
that for
the last minute,
half.
We've called a penalty. We don't know where it is. Someone's out of play. Confusion
that
running.
That call was. We're in the last minute.
And now we're worried about a bib. So.
So if New South Wales have got time, they can potentially convert this and go into half time with the match tied up. Let's see what they can do.
It's a horrible passage of play there for the Queenslanders. So Sherpig makes
throwing
amends.
Hands, yep, but the New South have still got possession.
Nathan Dart. Clearing the
calling
centre.
For the long ball straight in, but it didn't go. Now it's in. Let's see if we can convert this one.
Catalano.
Okay, all tied up.
Queensland, they want a quick one. They need it now. Sherpig needs to look long. Great pass, but not soon enough. One pass too many.
We've got a game here, Dave.
So we've played a half. 30 minutes gone, 30 to go, and we're at 22 all the twos. Probably not the cleanest game we've ever seen, but a very hard-fought contest. Third quarter, we'll be back when we come back in about 3 minutes.
Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au. Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au.
So, welcome back. Preliminary final day, AMNA Championships 2019, coming to you live from the Casey Stadium in Melbourne, Victoria. Proudly brought to you by Game Clothing, gameclothing.com.au. There's all our sponsors on the screen now. Time Umpire, Combat Netball, Melbourne Social Netball, Cluster Picks Photography, and of course, you can watch all these games as well on Netball Scoop, our broadcast partner, which is very hard to say quickly. So, my name's Dave Mills. I'm with here Jenny Lewis from the Victorian Open assistant coach, also Australian Resi's coach. We've seen a ding-dong battle, but probably not the highest standard we were hoping for, Jen.
Yeah, I'm a little bit torn on that. I think I've been commentating that I think there's been some good defensive pressure. It's not as free-flowing as either of these teams have played before, and but often that can be a combination of finals nerves, especially when it's a goal-for-goal game, as it is, all tied up. And also contesting. There's contesting on almost every ball here, so there's no easy balls to get through. I think the team that composes themselves first obviously will pull away. I am liking that before the game I predicted a 5-goal difference.
I predicted 25.
So I think I'm looking looking good. The goods here.
Calling the odds. So it's 22 all at the moment. Queensland, every time they got away, would give back the ball through silly errors. New South Wales, tenacious defence, and then some incredibly long bomb shooting from Rochelle Buzzard.
She's been great to watch. I've really enjoyed her shooting in this game, so hopefully she can continue that.
She's hit 7 from 11 in that quarter. I'd say that the 7 were all pretty at distance. Catalano, 7 from 9 for New South Wales. For Queensland, Dunphy's the man. He's hit 11 of 12. That's all the goals for them in that quarter. Shelford Salt only had the one attempt for a miss. That quarter there was 14-11 to the Blues to give us that 22 all scoreline. New South, they seem a very tight unit from what we're hearing just watching. They're very close to our bench here, the New South Wales bench, and they're very tight. A lot of confidence in the huddle.
And you can see that in the way they play. They back each other up. They look like a team.
Certainly
Queensland's got some very talented players, but New South Wales are matching them with good teamwork.
Looking a little disjointed, the Queensland team, is that what you're suggesting?
They look like they are quite connecting, as well as they certainly look like the talent's out there, just need to connect it.
So the goal to Rochelle Buzzard puts them one up, 23-22. So a result that's probably surprising a lot of people at present. Last time these two teams met, it was a big margin to the Queenslanders.
And
58-32, 26.
Missed there from Dunphy, contested by the two New South Wales defenders, and they've now got the opportunity to convert this.
So the error rate continues for Queensland. Gunn tries hard.
Good contest there by Sophie Gunn on the transition play. They'll need more of that from her if they're going to pull this margin away.
Incredible patience being shown here
Maddie
by the Blues,
Kirk,
isn't it?
Taking every second ball on transition at the moment, being an absolute workhorse out there. Unfortunately, the last pass was a cross-court pass, which Lusty read really well, and so Queensland now have an opportunity to get their centre pass back.
So the Blues miss an opportunity to go two up. They get it to Dunphy, throws it up, misses, gets his own board, and thankfully gets it in. Thankfully if you're a Queensland supporter. And again, we're tied at 23. So Gunn the chance, couldn't get it. Lusty just misses as well.
Lovely ball then from Maddie Kirk with Catalano driving into the post. Well
great
read,
drive
excellent.
From Catalano, wasn't it?
Excellent placement. Yeah.
Gunn, no one to throw to, finds Elliott. Wayward pass, can't link with Sherpid. New South Wales on the fly. Steps in, And we've got a contact
Holland
on
Elliot. A little bit lucky there, but she's been very composed through the game, and I'm sure she'll be safe on this one. And Tudor was called for a push-off there.
Unfortunate push-off. Lusty with the ball. No one to throw to.
And well intercepted Holland. By Holland there. Showed what she can do on the with her defensive work, which, as I said yesterday, I thought was very impressive.
The ball goes out.
A little bit of an ambitious pass there.
Good pressure by Bomeg. No one to throw to. The goal attack has to come a long way down.
A lot of errors being made by Queensland here, which is giving New South Wales the opportunity. So they just need to be able to finish off, and they can potentially capitalise and take a two-goal lead here. Long shot by which he converts. Lovely shooting.
Points to a bench. Sheer confidence shown by Rochelle Bichette. So gives the bench a big finger, the polite one. And it's a margin of two.
Give and go for Maddie Kirk to hit the circle, and a bit of an ambitious ball in. So it just needed a little bit of patience at the end of that cut and drive. So long ball up and contested well by Klulau, and he's converted. That's a big win for goalkeeper against such a strong holding goal shooter.
So
nice transition play by New South Wales. They've got another opportunity, Holland and Kirk, combining well in front of the circle. Just got to finish off into that feed, and a good look-away pass there from Buzzard, showing all his skills, and conversion by Catalano.
Catalano, the goal.
New South Wales have done taken a three-goal lead.
So, should be a timeout from Queensland soon. Need to address this situation. So, Elliot with the ball, looks for Gunn.
We've got a State of Origin match here. Dave, who's commentating with me, is a bit of a Queensland men's netball icon. So I'm, having lived in Sydney for 10 years, I'm putting on the New South Wales jersey here. And,
and the lucky shot
just
there.
To balance out
the
my
lucky shot there by Dunphy. I'm neutral. Can you believe that? I can bridge this earlier. So another long bomb, and
lovely
boom, she gets it.
Buzzard.
Buzzard taking it away from the Maroons at the moment. Gunn runs back. Need to get something out of the front too.
Blues are nice and composed here. They just need to keep that composure, put the pressure on, and the turnovers will come.
Shelford Salt, great feed in.
Great feed in, yeah.
Finds Dunphy. A little bit of rhythm starting to come to the Maroons. Still two down. Great drive there by Holland. So Catalano gets
great
it in good position.
Great timing then from Catalano to cut the baseline. And a nice offload from Buzzard.
Gunn working hard. Looks in. Oh, a loose
well
pass.
Well done, Maddie Kirk. She's had a very good game.
Shelford Salt, the loose pass. New South Wales in transition.
New South Wales have good momentum.
Holland with it. Will she look long? No, passes off, uses a triangle. Gunn picks it up. Lucky break to Queensland.
Okay, one of the teams needs to settle here. There's a few errors, and there's another error from Queensland.
Jen Lewis being polite with a few errors. It's an error first. So
whoever settles first here.
What do you call a large group of errors? Gluttony?
We call the third quarter the premiership quarter. I thought that was out of bounds, actually, but got to capitalise on your luck.
Umpires didn't see it. You are the most polite commentator we've ever had. So this is a chance to go four up.
And a lovely long shot from Buzzard.
Nothing but net. She's starting to chant, getting the team fired up. Rochelle Buzzard. Catalano doing his part well. Lusty has a chance.
And Lusty coming in to contest that has created the turnover for
just
Queensland.
There.
Let's see if they can settle, because they've been quite erratic on the last few plays. So they need to get their transition work going.
Quite
is that
erratic.
Better?
That's beautiful. Words of poetry from Jenny Lewis. Jenny Lewis at hotmail.com. There's a man down. We've had a head bump.
Fall.
Someone's got to call something, surely. Yeah. Umpires, there is a man on the
that
floor.
That was a nasty fall, and we think he might have hit his head on the way through, but he's up and playing.
And we just played through it. Surely common sense has to kick in at some stage.
Yeah.
So the margin is 3.
He's rubbing his temple a little bit. So hopefully, it's Nathan Dart from New South Wales. Hopefully he's okay to keep continuing.
Well, he's running around like he is, but he did whack his head pretty hard on the floor.
Yeah.
In this era of concussion injuries, you think they'd call it. So Dunphy pulls it in. Queensland get it back to 2.
So Queensland have settled a bit.
It's the closest they've been in a while. So Holland, great straight driving.
Nathan Dart's still rubbing his temple. Hopefully he's okay.
Maddie Kirk finds a hot hand. And she continues to be a
hot
hand.
Great long shot from Rochelle Bizard.
And doesn't mind telling people about it. Big smirk.
We love it.
Bit of fire in the belly.
She has to show confidence.
And boy, is she showing it.
That's good to see. Love it.
Zach Dunphy keeps Queensland within 2. Oh, cheap foul there from Sherpig. New South Wales settle.
Now New South is starting to
few errors
lose their
composure.
Getting the ball into the attack end third. So if they want to capitalise on this little lead they've created, they just need to readjust that and settle. They were playing some beautiful netball early in the quarter.
Elliot goes long.
And there's a good long ball.
And there is a contact. It will lay it up. So Queensland, through all the errors, have fought back to be within 1. They got a chance to tie it up. Blues led by as much as 4. Sherpig, no one to throw to. Nearly a hell ball. It was.
Good contest in there by Catalano to create that turnover. So opportunity for New South to refocus. Ball at the edge of the circle. And another opportunity for Bizard to put
hot
in a
hand
long
Luke
shot.
And she just misses that one. Catalano saves it and whips it back in.
Lovely rebound there from Catalano. Good balance. And opportunity for
she misses
to
2.
She looks more comfortable, as you said earlier, from range. So
New South Wales just hungrier for the ball at the moment.
Yep.
Queensland had 4 bites at that one.
Oh.
Loose pass. So Lusty's all over it.
Catalano was still coming through on his move when the pass was already released, so created an errant ball there. Another touch by Catalano. Great save by Holland. Unfortunately, she was just out of court. So.
Elliot was lucky there. Didn't chase hard. Holland nearly snabbled it. Lusty calling for it. Queensland in disarray at present.
Steps into the ball. Was called as a contact. But
basic netball stuff, Jen.
We need to adjust those stepping in.
So, Meg Bowmaker, no one to throw to, goes back again. There's just no movement coming from the front end.
New South to slow up the transition.
Drop
the deck again.
Drops his shoulder into Sherpig. So, and the long ball in. Oh, just
long
gets
ball.
There.
Nice roll from Klulau then to try and create some confusion, but it was a perfect pass, so comes off for Queensland.
So 30-all, Queensland fighting hard. They get back. They were down by 4.
A bit
Elliot.
Of a sloppy pass then. We don't want to bounce the ball. You don't want to bounce the ball in the midcourt, do we, Dave?
I can't believe what I'm seeing right now.
Maybe bounce it into the goal circle, but midcourt's a bit dangerous. Having said that, we've got a conversion opportunity from New South. Missed shot. And an opportunity for Queensland again.
You just keep saying the word opportunity, so they're coming thick and fast.
Someone needs to take it, don't they?
It's
a final, and it's an even with 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Often how finals go, and it's amazing how when we see games that blow out during the rounds, and once you hit the finals, those same two teams can be even in the middle of the game.
Don't forget,
and that's exactly what's happening here.
Don't forget, the winner of this will play the winner of the previous game, which was Victoria. They took care of the ACT. This grand final will be on Saturday at 9 a.m. We are broadcasting it. It'll be from Court 10, and we will be live streaming that one to you. But the best way to enjoy it is to come on down. The hot hand of Rochelle Bizard hits anothery, gives the margin of 1 to New South Wales. Another hell ball coming there.
Thought that was a hell ball, but he just piffed it, basically, long to his shooter. It's always a nice outlet to have if you've got a really tall shooter when you're in trouble.
Desperation on the Queenslanders.
You never know what'll happen, and that paid off.
So, working hard. They need a turnover. The Blues not giving up much this quarter. So
some pretty tight circle defence in here this quarter by Queensland. New South had a bit of a run, but New South is now having trouble feeding from circle edge because Lusty and Bowmaker are putting some really good pressure there, some really tight man-on-man defence. So this now has now given Queensland another opportunity to take the lead.
He misses
for the
first
time in this quarter.
Gets the second. Don't forget, you can contact us through all our socials. Bowmaker has got an injury. She's coming
actually
off.
Actually, that's a shame because I've just called how she was creating some great turnover ball.
I think Renata's coming on. She will
Let's
replace Bowmaker. Didn't have the happiest of first quarters. Threw the ball away a lot. So hopefully she gets control of her game now. Looks long straight
there's
up.
There's another long ball. So there's a new game plan that Queensland have thrown in the last two plays. Just long court ball. So Simon Clulow will adjust to that and we'll start to see his opportunity on those if Queensland keep putting them through.
So don't forget, you can contact us through all the socials. We're on the Facebook, we're on the Twitter, we're also on Instagram.
Nice offload then.
The hashtag is unmissable. And the other hashtag is Aussie Champs 2019. We're getting some calls in through now. People coming through, some former Queensland players, former captain Angela Rose. She's giving us a shout out. And many of the other players that have represented this great state. So Queensland, with the goal there, get the margin to 2:34:32. But the hot hand from New South Wales, she doesn't do it this time. Rochelle Bissaud. She's had an impressive third quarter, Jen.
Yeah, the momentum has really changed here in the last 3 minutes. New South Wales had a 3-goal lead and ball to go 4 up. They've actually started releasing long balls into their shooter in the last few minutes and it's paying off for them.
So
and have created some really good circle defence
so
pressure.
So at this stage, Queensland are winning the quarter 13-10. Ooh. Now 14-10. So at 36-32, coming into the last quarter. And a break
and
here.
A break.
Good work by Renata forcing that.
So New South Wales just need to show some patience to keep the scoreboard pressure on. 4 goals is, given that there's so many turnovers in this game, there's not a lot to pull back.
Another forced ball.
They need to just find their composure again.
We had 40 seconds left. There was no need to throw that. New South Wales will have a chance to score here. So... and a step. Queensland get it back. Quick feet by Elliott.
A few turnovers in the last two
finds
minutes.
Renata.
Players are starting to tire. They just need to reset themselves at the three-quarter time break. There's another turnover.
Another footwork call.
A lot of footwork calls down this end of the court. I don't know whether that's because players are tired or it's quite technically being umpired. But
we'll find out in the last quarter. And we will indeed. So the quarter comes to an end. It's a 14-10 quarter to Queensland, making the margin 36-32. They lead by 4 going into the main break. They would have thought they'd have a bigger lead than that. New South Wales, ridiculously tenacious in defence, and the hot hand of Rochelle Bissaud and steadiness of Steve Catalano has brought them back into the gatch. What will happen? We'll see after these messages.
Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam, and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au.
Back for this final quarter in the 2019 AMNA Championships national titles to be held here at the Casey Stadium in Melbourne. We're watching a mixed reserve match between the Queensland team and, of course, the New South Wales side. The current score, Queensland 36-32. Jenny Lewis, my co-commentator, your thoughts on that first three quarters?
Well, the game was all tied up at half time. New South Wales was showing a lot of composure in their attack end, hitting the circle to feed, putting in some nice feeds, and they managed to pull the third quarter out to a 3-4 goal lead. However, then the Queensland defenders seemed to tighten up, and it was tough for the New South Wales feeders to find their target. Shooting was reasonable. A couple of missed shots were punished because Queensland started throwing some long balls into their tall goal shooter, which he was able to take and convert. They were placing that a little bit better than they were in the first half towards the end of that quarter, and as a result they've now got a 4-goal lead going into the final quarter. Having said that, anyone's game.
It is indeed.
Because there's a lot of turnover balls, so there's a lot of opportunity for a gap to close. I think if New South can keep the gap within four, then they can keep themselves in this match.
So Dunphy hits all 14 from 16 in that quarter.
One change, I did notice that the goalkeeper for New South was limping off the court at three-quarter time, and as a result they've had to make the change, and they've brought Dart into goalkeeper, and Isaiah Jericho, I think it is, into wing defence.
So Queensland get the first in this second period.
Isaiah Samworth, sorry.
Sorry. And they get the margin out to five. So for Queensland, 14 out of 16 to Dunphy in that quarter. For New South Wales, hot hand Buzzed hits 7 out of 9. Catalano is doing his bit, 3 out of 4 at 75%. Interestingly, since they've changed goal attacks, only one attempt for no goal scored from the Queensland goal attack in Kiwa Shelford Salt. If she could increase her volume, it might just free up the circle a little bit and take a bit of pressure off Dunphy. But a turnover there. We've got 14 to play, Queensland by 6. Jen, what's your opinion? What are you tipping?
Unfortunately for New South, they've lost a lot of height with Simon Clulow limping off at three-quarter time. So I'm sure Dart will do a great job on the contest, and he managed to get a turnover ball just then. But I just think the height advantage for the Queensland goal shooter is going to allow them to keep some composure in this last quarter. As I said that, there's a turnover.
A drop ball. Called replay. So hot hand. Lusty gets it on the up.
There's a reject from Lusty.
Don't see that a lot these days with the rule change a couple of years back. But he got that one on the up. Don't forget you've got to pick a player of the game here. Jen.
Yeah, I'm sure with respect to that reject, Buzzard looks like a very experienced goaler, and I'm sure it won't affect her shot. Having said that, it just did.
She second-guessed herself, threw in the balk, and missed by a fair margin. So
who are you looking at for options for player of the match?
That's the beautiful thing about doing my job.
You're looking at Queensland, Dave.
Oh, that's your call, Jen. I just sit here and call it like I see it.
Realistically, the goal shooter's been pretty dominant.
From New South Wales or from Queensland? Yeah, both. Both shooters have been outstanding.
And the goal shooter for New South has been very creative with her play, but also put in some great shooting, which has opened up the circle for them because they don't have to work it to the post because she's got really good range on her shot. Having said that, a couple of errors now. She just needs to settle herself back into the game. She's had a terrific game up till now.
Lusty's done a fair job himself. Sophie Gunn's been fairly solid for Queensland. The Blues, I can't go past Rochelle Buzzard and Catalana. They've been a great combination.
They have, yeah, so. They've kept them in the game.
Oh, the magic pass from Shelford Salt.
Maddie Kirk's also been a workhorse for New South Wales.
So the margin 7, 12 to play. If Queensland can just make it error-free from here, they should do enough to get home.
I have a feel like Lusty in defence in the last about 15 minutes of play has really started to create some confusion then. And as a result, Queensland have blown out to a 6-goal lead. The wing defence is now called and they're making a change.
Georgia Elliott off. Meg Bowmaker recovered from that shocking injury. And she's on court. I don't know, I'm picked up on my sarcasm there. I just think it's a silly rule.
Oh, and we've got an intercept and unfortunately a stepping call from Catalano. So,
Jen, I'll ask you this. Have you seen a semi-final that's had so many footwork calls?
No. And they're all at one end of the court.
Yeah, that is true. Are you suggesting maybe there's a technicality that we're not seeing?
Potentially.
Cool. Third time's a charm for the big man, Dunphy. Phil's brother, Zach, makes no mistake. playmaker under a player gets called for the contact.
New South Wales still need to make composure. There's still 11 minutes to go. No need to rush. Put the scoreboard pressure on, and sometimes that can create the errors. Unfortunately, another missed shot from Buzard. She's just lost a little bit of composure this quarter, so I'm sure she's able to regroup that.
Great clearance by Gunn onto Renata. That was nice play by Queensland. That's what we saw a lot of this morning's game. Not so much today, but that was probably their best passage of play.
Yes, I was about to say, very decisive through transition then.
So something seems to have clicked all of a sudden. Contact on Kirk. So Gunn, she'll look to feed it. She'll look straight in the big man. No, she doesn't. Oh, hell ball.
Maybe could have offloaded that to the...
She's done it so well, you think it would have happened there. Seize the moment, they say. 41-38.
New South Wales have to maintain composure here to stay in the game.
So
Buzard needs to finish this shot, which she does. Got another opportunity to bring it back in with six, and then they just need to keep the scoreboard pressure on.
Buzard has one of the best techniques you'll ever see. So...
Yeah, she's not an overly tall shooter, but has a lovely technique and good composure on the shot, and not afraid to put the shot up.
And again.
And they bring it back to six.
41-35. Queensland were running away with it. Got a contest again, Jenny.
We do. See how Queensland can maintain that. Yeah, I just think that long ball into the shooter now is it's going to be tough for New South Wales to create a lot of pressure around that.
And Dart, of course, we think he banged his head pretty hard on the floor earlier in the third. So again.
And a lovely shot, lovely finish from Bouchard. New South just need to stay in the play. They need to have really tight pressure across wing defence, goal defence, centre in order to create those conversions, which they've just achieved on the centre pass.
In possession, it gives away a break whilst in possession. Jen, we call them coach killers.
Opportunity for New South around the edge of the circle here. Just need to create a little bit of movement maybe in the circle, because it's getting quite tough to feed it in. Contact call then. Creates an opportunity for Buzard. I'm assuming she might, given the rest of the game, she'll have a go at this shot.
Lusty, too close. She'll go again, steps in.
And they bring it back to five with a centre pass to come.
Adam Zemski, Queensland coach, I looked over him. He's got a frustrated look on his face. Understandable. Queensland, their error rate.
Nice give and go from Collins then to create the edge of the circle opportunity, and a good finish from Buzard, back within four.
We keep giving it to Buzard. She's going to keep scoring. So Queensland need to just tighten up for a bit. New South Wales will come all day. Oh, he misses it. And contacts on the second. The small man, Dart, put his body on the line. Out of play.
Here's the opportunity that New South Wales were looking for, so can they maintain their composure and work it through?
Oh, we've got a break in play. We're getting the sponge out. It's a brilliant job. Queensland.
I don't know how I respond to that.
It's been a highlight. New South Wales working it through.
New South Wales just need to keep that structure. Long, nice long ball from Holland into the post.
Lusty gets the boards.
And
he was out of play when he touched it.
Out of court by the looks of it. Yep. So an opportunity for Buzard to put some ball pressure on. And she finishes off.
Indeed, she does. She has a hot hand. So the margin's three. I repeat, three. Queensland had it to eight not that long ago.
New South Wales need to keep attacking here.
String of errors has brought New South Wales back into it.
And here's another opportunity for Buzard. The contact calls are giving her free shots, so Queensland maybe need to tighten that up a bit. And she converts, and it's back to two. Game on again.
She's calling it up. 42-40. New South Wales coming home with a wet sail. Queensland need not panic, but you think they might throw a long bomb in that goes over the baseline. Or a short one that gets intercepted by the smallest person in the circle.
Then to get around the body, outside arm. Any juniors watching? Perfect execution of the intercept then. And the shot is rejected by Lusty.
He's done it well. Gunn doesn't want to pick it up.
Someone needed to bounce on that ball then, and Queensland did. So they've got the opportunity.
There's a contact on the outside.
Yourself might regret not converting that one, but...
Well, it would have made it one.
Exactly.
So, I think they might.
Oh, and we've got a stepping, a bit of an experience here showing from the Queensland goal shooter on the last couple of plays. So,
I wish we had a replay.
The rest of his team really just needs to get around him and settle him.
We've got another change. This time Renata's coming off, Elliott going back on. So, Adam Zemski is ringing the changes till he finds a combination that's working. So close there. New South Wales looking composed. Bowmaker with another contact. Elliott. Can she put some pressure on this incredible shooter from New South Wales?
Oh, and just a passing error, but a nice deflection to follow her own error. Missed shot and rebound from Catalano.
Third time, fourth time
another
coming up
rebound.
Now. He's
and
had
it's
four
now
goes.
One goal.
They've got it.
One goal with centre pass to convert. 5 minutes to go.
We've got a humdinger here, ladies and gentlemen. New South Wales down by eight not that long ago.
Another stepping call. Awkward landing on the intercept.
Frustration by Sherpig. He'd be better off getting the ball back. And there it is. Thank you.
Awful lot of whistle in this quarter, Dave.
There's been a bit of whistle for the entire match, Jen.
Neither team's able to get much flow.
So it's been one of those games. Apparently this is finals netball.
Almost a
absolute replay. We've had technical steppings, but we missed that.
Game is all tied up.
Caught it, dropped it, picked it up. Replay in the best definition you'll ever see. So...
Queensland seemed reluctant to let it go to the tall shooter. Which they were doing beautifully in the third quarter.
Indeed. Margin 1, 43-42. Queensland expected to win in a canter, struggling to get this job done. New South Wales, amazing tenacity.
Important at this stage not to freeze up and to keep attacking the play. And keep releasing the ball. New South Wales have just done that.
Queensland through Sophie Gunn, a long pass, great chase, but we have a contact in the circle, do we, or where do we have it? Yes, in the circle.
So I'm assuming this will be offloaded to shoot her under the post. Nope, shots up.
She hasn't made one all day.
He's able to get the rebound.
Possibly that was a pass, maybe she threw it over. We'll still call it a pass.
Now you're being the good cop.
Okay, it was a shot and it was terrible. There you go. So New South Wales.
Okay, nice release from...
Do we do overtime? Bizarre. That's what I want to know. Do we get paid for
it's
that?
It's a final.
I think it's seven each way if we go to overtime. Hot hand.
And a nice shot from Bizarre to even up, so it's whoever can maintain their composure in the last 3 minutes.
44 all with three to go. Queensland.
Nice releases from Queensland. Oh. That was good access to the circle. That's all they need to do. Keep simple netball.
Sherpig threw it from the hip. Thought it was going to go over the baseline.
So New South Wales.
Holland looks
well
long.
Done. So
finds an unmarked shooter. Under the ring. No one there.
And a contact call on Lusty. So just got a nice conversion of the shot for Bizarre from underneath.
Bizarre, what a match.
She's a really good range shooter and she's just proved she can shoot under pressure as well.
Queensland with the centre. Oh, contact. Sorry.
Okay, so the wing attack for Queensland is starting to get edge of the circle, but he did throw that one away. So another opportunity for New South Wales.
There's a lot of noise here. More New South Wales supporters than Queenslanders. So, going hard. Oh, he gets a back shot. No, he doesn't. Nearly. He's trying too hard. He'll give away obstruction shortly.
Samua's having a lot of the ball now. He's nice. He's come on at three-quarter time and is showing good composure.
Catalano gets a chance. Doesn't make it.
And there's a missed shot, which creates an opportunity for Queensland.
And it throws it away again.
Nice pick up there.
George Elliott to nobody.
From Emily Kirk. And here's
Catalano.
An opportunity for Catalano again. He's missed a few in the last bit of it. Converts that one.
1:30 to play. It's their centre, the Blues. It's theirs to lose now. 1:25. They've got the ball. Queensland need a miracle. That won't do it.
Emily Kirk's having a great goal quarter, last quarter in goal defence. Good drive then from Holland, releasing it to Buzard. She needs to make sure she keeps attacking the post in the last minute. Don't want to contain too much.
Gunny round, can't get it. Elliot. Oh. The clock
contact
is not Queensland's friend. This goal will do it. If New South get this, they'll do it. She kicks it out using a few more seconds, finds a spot. And Elliot, an inexplicable foul from behind. Lusty does well, but Elliott's out of play, can't pick it up.
Okay, so
Catalano can win it. Checks his hair on the way up. Misses.
Rebounds.
Just taking time off the clock and does it. Queensland need an incredible miracle now. New South have got to go long. They do. He drops it cold, the shooter. Gets the contact. We're calling time. I don't know why we do this in the last minute and not every the other 59.
Oh, and a great touch from
Dart. Okay, and there's the... No, he misses again with call time.
This is all using up time.
So Queensland get one. It's 46. So New South Wales literally have to hold it for about 10 seconds, I estimate. And we've got a break.
And we've got a break in
Elliot, they've called time again. Elliot, she goes. They've got to go long. They've got to go long. This to tie it up.
Oh, there's a stepping call.
She's called stepping, and now time is gone.
And New South Wales
Queensland are shocked.
Here.
I cannot believe what has happened.
I'm not sure if we have vision on this, but New South Wales team is absolutely ecstatic.
Queensland are devastated. The call was stepping on the shooter. They're carrying on like they've won the whole tournament, and maybe they have on that performance. Queensland devastated. I cannot believe it.
Terrific composure from New South Wales, Dave, to fight that game out from four goals
down. The shooting from Bazaar is as good as I've seen in 25 years of netball.
Player of the match.
Oh, that's your call. I'm happy. I'm just an observer.
Zach Dunphy, goal shooter for New South Wales.
Devastated. Well, not supposed to tell that until after the break. So Zach Dunphy, he's the one. He's devastated. He's not with his teammates at the moment. New South Wales. Levert down by 8 in that quarter, came back to win it by 1, 47-46. We'll be back with the player of the game after these messages.
player of the match from New South Wales, fantastic game.
Thank you very much.
I thought you showed an awful lot of composure as a goal shooter in such a close final.
Yeah, it's really tough to keep your composure. You've got to have the focus, and I have to sink in the shots of the hard work that my teammates have done bringing it down. If it wasn't for them, it wouldn't be possible.
We were very impressed with commentary with your shooting range, and you know, certainly opened up the circle for you and made the feeder's job comfortable.
Yeah, I've got to, as I said, I've got to go from anywhere. I've got to turn and shoot, and that was what my coach said, and I'm happy that I was able to do it, and I'm so pleased and so glad.
I also love how excited your teammates are at you getting this Player of the Match award.
Though. I know. It's a shock.
So what do you have to focus on for tomorrow?
We just got to go, come back, we've got to rest, recover, and we just got to come out and do it again. Our mixed reserve team's been in the grand final match for the past 2 years, and we've come silver. This year, yeah. We're coming for the gold. Yeah. We're going all out.
Okay, well, all the best with that.
Thank you so much.
And looking forward to seeing your grand final and fantastic performance.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Excellent. Well, that's a great interview, man of the match. One of the best performances I've seen from Rochelle Bizard. Incredible shooting. Gets New South Wales up by one, 47-46. Queensland threw everything at it, but in the end, their error rate just was a bit too much for them. So that concludes that game. Tomorrow we will have at 9 o'clock that New South Wales side you just watched will take on the Victorian side in the final. Coming up next, we have a mixed open preliminary final between Queensland and New South Wales. Don't leave this channel, but at the moment, thanks to Jenny for coming with us and commentating with me. And after that, we'll be back shortly with the next game. Bye for now.
I would be nothing without you holding me up. I'm strong enough for both of us, both of us, both of us, both of us. I am a giant, standing up on my shoulders, tell me what you see. I am a giant, we'll be breaking boulders underneath our feet.
Get over Anderson,
it
back
it
in,
is.
Does.
And he's lobbed in, but what a goal!